Hey everybody, Dr. Kranke here in the laboratory, doing a little bit of pre-painting, as I call it, or paint experimentation to avoid heartache. I think it also goes hand in hand with preparation and making sure that you avoid surprises, you avoid mistakes. And Dave Parker, this is a way to answer your question about primers and about buffing plastic and all of that good stuff, which you're not the only one who's been asking. So I'll just go ahead and maybe do a little bench talk here and get it out in the open finally. I do cover it in my book. And, a lot of people think that my book is just on rusty vehicles. No, it's a, it's just, rusty. Yeah. Rusty's important. And we do a lot of rust in that book, but there's also, stuff on creating shiny paint jobs, making sure that, you get the smoothest, shiniest of, shines, and that's actually using my method, working with House of Color and other urethanes. Not so much with the Don Yost method, which is on enamels, and we'll talk a little bit about that in a minute. I don't want to make a 15-20 minute video. For some reason, iMovie doesn't let me go beyond 15 minutes, which is perfect. Although I can upload as much video as I want, up to I think 45 minutes or something like that, which would be ridiculous. Nobody should ever have to sit through a 45-minute video, or at least I can't, because I have stuff to do and I don't have the attention span. Remember, Dr. Kranke's OCD, OCD, ADHD, all of those D's, like demented. Anyway, back to the subject. Primers. I'm in the process of, as I said, I've got the paint ready for the 1950. It's a lovely, lovely, very dark metallic green. It ended up almost being like a British green. You could almost see it there. A lot of bling in this paint. This is going to be the base coat for a little experiment I'm going to try. Okay. Now, everybody has two choices. You have two ways of going about this. You could do it the way that I used to do it, which, it's a 50-50 shot. 50% meaning that you are going to get a great job on that paint job, or 50% it's going to go back into the purple pond. And so you learn after a while, and I keep moving these around. Ooh, yes, plastic spoons. Get your hands on these. These are heartbreak savers, these plastic spoons. You can get them in all kinds of shape, different colors. I just picked these up, I think, from Panera's or something like that. My wife brought lunch and soup and all that. And, plastic spoons are very interesting. You can use them as fender skirts if you cut them. You can use them for all kinds of neat stuff. But also, look, I don't know if you could see the design. There's the design right there. This is almost the shape of it makes for like a panel for an interior, like one of those middle consoles. Fabulous stuff. So it's good to have them around. I use plastic spoons for a whole variety of purposes, but mostly to practice my paint. Okay, so naked styrene spoon, okay, which already comes as shiny can be, okay? It comes like that from the factory, okay? Now, we will pretend this is a model car. So, you could take this, and if you don't see any blemishes on your model car, no welt lines, no sink marks, no flash, no scripts you want to remove, no emblems, no trim, nothing. If the model car looks perfect to you, then you could take it to the next level, which is if you're going to go the Don Yost route with the enamel, you can spray it with aluminum plate, okay? And you're good to go. The aluminum plate creates a tooth upon which the paint will stick. All right. Now, the Kranke method, which is the method that I think everybody has been using when you're dealing with House of Color or any other paint system, even including acrylics. Okay. And, old school enamel folks. You know, you could go and primer. And now primer, I have my handy primer. This is the primer that I use exclusively. There is no other primer for me. Plastic Coat Gray. It comes in white. It comes in black. And it comes in ruddy brown. And I'm sure there are a couple of other colors. But I use white if I want the colors to come out really pop. I use black if I'm using a lot of metallics. Or I use the gray if I'm going to go in any direction. You apply it. You apply the primer to the smoothest surface you possibly can. So back to your model. You can take this and sand it and buff it all the way to 12,000, which I tend to do because, again, I smooth out panels, I remove door handles, I remove trim, all of that good stuff, okay? And then I buff it, make sure that you've got an original, once again, smooth surface. And then I buy myself a little extra insurance and I put primer on there. If you are going to use lacquers or urethanes, urethane lacquers, whatever, you know, hot paints, in other words, you want to primer because if not, you know, you're going to risk adhesion and you're going to risk ruining, crazing the plastic. Okay. Cause some lacquers and urethanes are hot, perhaps even too hot. So, you know, you want a primer, to create a coat. Some people will seal. Dave, you were talking about, the ghosting, you know, where, you know, the panels and panel lines and stuff come back and get ghosted through the paint. Yeah, that happens all the time. So you have to primer and you have to seal, okay? You also have to be mindful of coat thickness, which is why I like to use House of Color. House of Color goes on very thin, and so you can add layers and layers and layers and not lose detail. Whereas with enamel, you have to be very, very careful, which is why Don Yost uses the aluminum plate. Because it creates a nice base coat that's going to make your metallics and your candies and what have you really shine. And you'll see that metallic base there. It makes it really cool. But it also provides a nice tooth. Now, if something goes wrong and you've used aluminum plate and you put it in the purple pond, at least with the power degreaser, that purple power that I use, it's going to take a couple of days, whereas with the primer, with the plastic coat, oh my goodness, I've dunked bodies into that stuff, and within the hour, I've already stripped it back down to the plastic. So it's a matter of time, you know, which is also the reason why I will often prep a couple of the same models to have the extra parts, just in case something goes terribly wrong. And I don't want to spend too much time waiting and waiting and waiting again in patience. Okay, so practice on plastic spoons. You will see next time you see these, they'll probably be painted in with that green. I'm prepping because I'm also going to practice my little realistic flames on the spoons. I figured if I can get the effect on a spoon, which is very small, I should be able to transfer it to a 1/24th scale model. And have it look pretty good. So anyway, if you have any more questions, let me know. But Dave, that's usually the explanation right there of the method that I use, what I go through. Primer, when in doubt, use primer. That's the lesson of the day. The learned the hard way by yours truly. Ruined a lot of models, thinking, you know, it's enamel, I'll go naked styrene. Primer. Even when I use acrylics, sometimes if the weather is not with me, then I use a Vallejo resin acrylic primer that's pretty darn good. And since it's, you know, acrylic paints are not hot, you're not going to have any problem. But you know, adhesion is still a problem, and of course, acrylic paints and water normally don't mix. But there are ways of working with it. The Rocket Silo has a lot more experience with auto air, so he might be able to answer some of these technical questions a lot better. But anyway, you know, if you have any more questions, let me know. As you can see, I'm in the process of painting, getting some painting done, and getting the body ready, because the chassis is ready, the engine is ready, the interior is almost ready. And I think this is going to be pretty cool if all goes well. If not, then it's back to the purple pond with the body. That's the nature of the way these things work. That's why building models, it's not set up to drive you crazy. You should take your time, be patient. You know, things I should even listen to myself and remember. You know, you put a lot of time, you invest a lot of time and attention. So get it right, do it right. Enjoy the process. Otherwise, if you get frustrated, walk away. You know, go for a walk, take some time and exercise or something. Anyway, we'll be back. This one went on a little bit too long, but I wanted to make sure that you understood the importance of using primers. And again, plug it all the time. Plastic Coat, for me, for Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory, there is no better primer. I buy this stuff by the caseload. And every once in a while, I wake up in the middle of the night in a cold sweat thinking that I've run out. That's it. And one can will do about 3-4 models. So anyway, back to you. Bye-bye. Bedtime is in. It's cranky time.